Hi there, I'm Natasha Antonioni, lifestyle expert and realtor here in Austin, Texas. Today we are talking about Austin Airbnb best practices, and we have a guest with us today, Beth Friedman from Walker Luxury Vacation Rentals. Yes. All right, so let's just dive right in.
So best practices can mean a few different things.
Yeah.
Starting with doing it above board, Austin can be complicated in the world of short-term renting. So you wanna have a permit. Now, there are different kinds of permits to get depending upon the property that you have. Mm-hmm. And there are also exceptions to needing the permit depending upon where in the city you are.
Right.
So it's best when you go into this business to either hire a management company who's gonna help you sort of navigate through all of the questions that'll come up with the permitting. In any event, to just at least do the research online, because there are taxes that need to be paid, there's financials that you need to know and understand. So getting a permit is one of the first things that you need to do.
It's like any business. I think a lot of times when I'm working with a client that might be looking for an Airbnb, they don't think about it as a business, but really you can get in trouble if you Airbnb without a permit. There's also parts of Austin that are called the ETJ, which is the Extraterrestrial District, which means that you don't need the permit. You're out of what's considered the city limits and the city development plan. However, the thing to note is that that could change over time.
Yes.
And I think it's like probably a long time away, but it's important to kind of know the risk, right?
Right. And, you know, we're not trying to make it sound complicated, because it's really not. That's why it's important to work with a realtor like you, who knows and understands the market, mm-hmm. and a management company
property
like
management
us, company. Yep. Who knows how to keep track of what the rules are to make sure that we're following them.
Yes, we can help, so you're not alone. Let's talk about being a great host.
Yeah, that's hugely important.
Well, tell us like what your company does to kind of stand out.
To start off with, we make sure that the house is in perfect condition when guests show up, and we don't bother them. We don't, you know, they arrive and they're getting settled, and they don't need a host, you know, breathing down their neck. Oftentimes, you know,
peeking over the fence.
Exactly. You know, a lot of times people who arrive at a house, if it's self-managed, oftentimes the host will greet them. And that is good for some people, not so good for other people.
It's kind of nice to have that buffer.
Right, people like to, they're doing this to have
to get away. Yes.
And they want to live like a local. And so they show up at the house, and there should be a keypad instead of a lockbox is really a best practice, a seamless check-in. So they show up and they know where it is. We have an app, so each house that we manage, there's an app attached to that. Mm. And the app is just something that is handy for them so that they know the code to get into the house, and they have instructions on how to operate things. Where's the supermarket? We also have a concierge service if they want.
Best practices are to have a systematic way
yes.
to do things.
Mm-hmm.
And when we were managing it ourselves, we had to do every text message question that they have, all of our bookings, stay on top of what the algorithm was, which we didn't do at all. When we finally went the path of property management, our numbers went up. So we were never lower than 9,000 a month and never more than 10,000 a month for a 5-bedroom house in Hill Country in Austin with a pool. And when we went the property management path, we bumped up to never below 12 and never above 14,000 a month. So the numbers bumped and
right.
we were set free.
Again, the best practices are, it's all in the details. It's all in making the guest feel like they are well taken care of, and that they have a friend here in Austin if they need something.
And with like with any business, you want them to have a repeat experience, right?
Right.
So,
yes.
Mm-hmm. Like as someone who managed it ourselves, I think we did a pretty good job of it. But working
but it was
with
work.
First of all, it was work.
Right.
But if they came back the next year, did they have the exact same experience? I'm not sure that I could have promised.
Right.
That.
And now we do that. And we do that, I mean, with little things too. Again, you know, when you go into a hotel, little thing. You go into the bathroom and they fold the toilet paper and there's a little sticker
That's
on it.
That's right.
And we do that. And the signs around the house, you know, if they need anything or to watch their step if there's a step.
Every house has 85 light switches, just to kind of know the simplicity and the systemization of the house.
Right. To make things easy on the guest and to be a good host is a best practice.
Yes, absolutely. And you do something that's also pretty special, which we did not do when we were our own hosts, which is follow up with the guests. And it also is a good way to help you get your reviews up, right?
Right.
Because the more reviews, what happens to your ranking?
It goes up.
Yeah.
You know, you want to get caught in that algorithm, and the more reviews you have, the better. The more reviews, the more views. You know, you want the listing to be viewed. You get more views by rising up on the search results. So it's all a big circle.
One of the things when I went the property management path that I was concerned about is that we were super hosts and it had taken a lot of effort to get there. And then I was concerned that we were going to be starting with a, you know, with a new company, and what was that going to do to our ranking? So
it's always so if you're starting over, you're starting over.
Yeah.
But it's like making an investment. It costs something to move ahead. It costs, you know, you've got to put money down in order to make more money. So it's the same kind of mentality. It's a matter of how is it being managed so that you're going to rise as quickly as possible.
Well, I'll tell you though, that very next month we made more money, and we never stopped making more money after that.
So it's not necessarily
a
bad, dangerous thing.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, so working with the management company will make you more money.
So I would say that one of the top best practices would be to work with a management company, because
unless you have really all the time, like if it's a
full-time job,
if it's a full-time house and you have a full, if you have all the time in the world to dedicate to it, and that's what you want your business to be and what you want your day and your life to be, then by all means.
I could see that for my life also, like one day, maybe when I'm ready to kind of retire, that our plan is to build a portfolio of these Airbnbs that one day when I'm not, you know, selling houses and running around and raising kids and all this stuff, and I have more time, that I could have, you know, a team of cleaning people, and I would set myself up so that I would take care of it.
Yeah, I
you
mean,
know?
Some people enjoy it. Most people don't. But some people enjoy it. And again, if it's a full-time career, then great. And you know, when I was short-term renting my beach pad, I enjoyed meeting people from all over the world. And at that time, I had the luxury of being able to dedicate time to it. So, but it is hard work, and it is a lot of work. And there are nuances to it that are complex. So just know what you're doing.
Or you can hire a professional management company. Austin is a hotbed for Airbnb properties and real estate at large. Can't go wrong with investing in an Airbnb here, right now, at this time. Make sure to hit that like button below if you like this video, and don't forget to subscribe because we have videos coming out every single week. We'll see you soon. Whoosh!